to move what? N minus 1 disk. From where? From source. To where? Destination. Okay? Through the use of my temporary variable. Okay? Through the use of my temporary variable. What do you call this? What is the way of writing this? The way of writing this is very simple like this. I am going to move what? N minus 1 disk from A to B. Can I write like that very clearly? From A to B using C. No, not using C. A to C. Or else we'll do one thing. We'll not write entire all those things. We're just going to write what is a thing that becomes even more easier. Okay, so let's take out this. I think if condition, you know very clearly how it came through and all. Okay, so the next one, you know what is that N minus 1 from A to B? That needs to be written. Okay, so from A to B means you are going to move Tower of Hanoi. See, I'm going to write the Tower of Hanoi like this. Tower of Hanoi, T-O-H. You need to write full. Okay, so what I need to move? I need to move N minus 1 disk from A to B. A to A is nothing but source. B, what is a B? B is nothing but my temporary variable. Okay, very clear, the first statement. Then I need to move what? I need to move the nth disk from A to C. Okay, I need to move it from N to C. So what I can write that? I can clearly write that entire thing like this. Again, Tower of Hanoi. Okay, right from what? You need to move the N disk. Okay, at the nth disk from A to C, which is nothing but source to destination. Okay, then again the Tower of Hanoi. From where? From, sorry, N minus 1, right? N minus 1 disk. From where? From B to C. What is B? Temporary place. From C, destination. You need to write full, okay? Don't write like what I'm writing. I'm not writing like that because just to save time, okay? So what is this? What is this? Nothing but whatever you see right here, okay? The thing what you see right here, I've written like this. Why I've taken N is equal to 1? Because if there is one disk, we have to talk about that also, right? If there's only one disk, I can move from A to C. There's no need for B and all, okay? To maintain that also, I've sort of written that. So there's nothing new that is coming through here, okay? Something which you basically know and only I've written like this. Okay, now let's go for the next one. What is the next one? That is the next thing to be done here. Okay, the next thing to be done is to make sure now we used to put this into perspective. Now, what is the meaning of putting it into perspective? What we want, we don't want to learn about, you know, what it is, writing a program for it, algorithm, that's all fine. But our main intention is to make sure that we find out what is known as the time complexity of this. Okay. Time complexity of this needs to be found out and what needs to be done for that. Okay, how it should be done and what needs to be done for that. That can be done in a very, very simplest of way like this. Okay, so I'm going to write that right here. Okay, first and foremost, very clear that, you know, this is what we call it as analysis part. Okay, we always call this as my analysis part. So when I go for an analysis part, what is the thing I need to keep in mind? First one, what is a parameter to be considered? What is a parameter? Of course, you know, input N, okay? Which is nothing but, you know, number of this will be, you know, the N will be depending on the number of this, which is nothing but input, okay? So parameter to be considered is your input size. Then the basic operation, this is very, what is the basic operation I'm trying to perform? The basic operation I'm trying to perform here is movement of disk. Is that correct? Very, very clear that it is nothing but movement of disk. This is my basic operation. I am shifting from one place to another. Okay, that's my basic operation. This is very important. Then what's the next thing? The total number of disks. Okay, you need to write it, put it in the form of a formula, right? At the end of it, when you find out everything, you need to put it in form of a formula. Then the total number of disks moved from using this recurrence relation can be shown how? Like this. In a very, very simple way, C of N is equal to what? How you can write? You can write it like this, 0, 1. Why I'm writing 0? Because if the number of disks is equal to 0, If the number of disks is 0, there is no movement. So it is 0. If the number of disk is equal to 1, A to C, direct. You write jump from A to C. There's no need for any B. Okay. That's the way you can write it. Or if there is more than one. Okay. Or we simple words, we write otherwise. What is the way of writing this? This becomes a recurrence relation. C of what? N minus 1. This N minus 1 everything is not something which is new. I'm writing the same thing of what you're going to get. Plus 1 plus again C of N minus 1. Okay. What is the meaning of this? Probably people may be thinking, what is the meaning of this? This is, I am moving this N minus 1. N minus 1 from where? From source to your temporary variable. Or in very simple words, can I write this as A to, what is temporary variable B? Okay. Can write like that, you know, the temp, one second, I'll move the screen. Okay. See this, this C N minus 1 is nothing but moving N minus this from what? Source to your, okay, temporary variable. So this, that will become what? A to B. Okay. And what do you think this is? This one, now you can see this, there is one here. Okay. What is this? This is nothing but moving that nth disk. What is that nth disk? Nth disk can be any disk. And how many, what is that nth disk? It is only one, now. If there's 10 disks, then that you are talking about the 10th disk. If there are 8, you are talking about it 8th disk. So what is that? There's only one disk. So only I have written that as 1. So basically what is this? This is moving the nth disk from where? From source to destination. Or in very simple words, A to C. And what do you call this again? You may be thinking, what is this? This one is nothing but you are moving n minus 1 disk from where? Temporary to your destination. Okay. Or in very simple words, what I can write? I can write this as B to your C. Okay. So this is entire thing of how our relation can be represented in terms of, you know, finding out the complexity, in terms of recurrence relation, in finding out the time complexity. Okay. This is how basically it works, but this is not the only thing we want. Okay. Everyone can easily get this, very easily can get this. So it's not a problem. But what happens after this? Okay. What happens after this? What you need to write after this becomes very important, right? Now what needs to be done further? Okay. What needs to be done for that? Okay. You need to find out the time complexity. Can I write that entire thing into, you know, form some sort of an equation now? I can write it, right? So I'm going to write this equation in form of a place where I'm going can easily find out the time complexity. Okay, so I'm just going to move the screen. One second. Hopefully, yeah, it moves now. Okay, so let's move the screen and let's work it for it. Okay, see, 0 and 1, we don't really care, because time complexity, though they are nothing but, you know, the base case conditions. Just move from one place to other. Okay, one this place from source to destination. There's no people who really go for that. Okay, what we go for is the place where we generally happens in form of a recurrence relation. So let's go and find out for that. C of n is equal to, the time complexity of C of n is equal to, how we are going to write C of n minus 1 plus 1, not doing anything extra, please keep that in mind. Okay, plus again C of n minus 1. Is that correct? Very much correct. Can I write this entire thing like this? 2 of 2c of n minus 1 plus 1. Okay. Can I write like this? Very simple. Just adding anything, nothing but. Okay. So can I write this entire thing like this? Please understand this step. If you can understand this step, the entire thing is all done. Okay. 2 of, I'll write this very, very careful. See this, I'm going to write the 2 here itself. No, I'm not doing anything. This c n minus 1, now I'm going to represent in terms of this one. So when I represent that like that, what is going to happen? See this entire thing, for c of n, I can write 2c n minus 1 plus 1. So if I substitute that, you know, n minus 1 by, sorry, n by your n minus 1, what is going to happen? It is going to come through like this. What? Like this. 2c of what? N minus 2 plus okay, plus 1, and of course the plus 1 here. So only the one what you see in the red stake here, the red color here, that is sort of represented like this. There is nothing new. Okay, I'm just substitution, that's all. This is called substitution rules. I'm just substituting tills, nothing more I am doing. Okay, I'm just doing the substitution aspect of it. Okay, so if you want further simplify this, okay, if I sort of further simplify this, what is going to happen? It's going to be happen like this. Okay, if I further substitute this, what is going to happen? It is going to happen like this. 2 square C of n minus 2 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, even if I further substitute this, what is going to happen? Which basically means I need to go sort of talk this. Say I'm not doing anything. 2 into 2, 2 square. Then 2 C, n minus 2, same thing. 2 into 1, 2 plus 1, already written like that. Okay, not doing anything next. Okay, then again, if I substitute this, what is going to happen? If I sort of do this, what is going to happen again? This will become what? This will easily become as 2 to the power of 3 C n minus 3 plus 2 will become more, one more. So it will become 2 square plus 2 plus 1. I skipped one step here. If you want, you could always find out how it is represented. You need to just substitute the values for this. Then at the one more step, you're going to get this one only. Okay. One more step, can I write? Can I write one more step? The next step would be, what will be the value of it? The value of this would be 2 to the power of 4. Okay. C n minus 4 plus, this will be one more. So 2 to the power of cube. Plus, this will be one more, so 2 square plus one more, so it is nothing but 2 plus 1. Okay, you go for the next step. Or now, I want to generalize thing. I want to generalize so that I'll get a value that is needed to me. If I try to generalize that, okay, so if I try to generalize that, what I can generalize this, if I have to write it in form of a n, what do you think this will become? Okay, what do you think this entire n, you know, form of an n, if I try to write that, what is going to this will become? 2, we can understand this, 2 to the power of n. Okay, wherever I have a number, I'm going to represent it in form of a n, you know, generalized form, n minus n, you can see, okay, you can see this, understand the values of this, this is 4, you have again now 4, I'm representing. See, in very simple terms, it means that wherever you got a number, in terms of any number, you represent in terms of n, that's all. That's called generalized formula, right? So if I do that, 2 to the power of n, C of n minus n plus 2 to the power of 3, which is nothing but n minus 1 plus, see this, you have 3. When 4 is n, 3 will be n minus 1, common sense. Then what do you call this? N minus 2, can write that 2 to power of n minus 2. Okay, then if I keep on writing like that up to year 1. Okay, up to year 1. Can I further simplify this? Okay, can I further simplify this? Yes, this will become 2 to the power of n, C of 0. Be careful why I am writing C of 0, n minus 1, 0. Plus 2 to the power of n minus 1, same, plus 2 to the power of n minus 2, da, 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 up to 1. Okay, can I write this as next any other things? Okay, can I write this as any other things? Okay, what is C0? I mean, anything if you get to know it, you'll probably know what is C of 0.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Hello? Sir, how do we get that n minus n?
What is the value of here? What is the value here? N minus 4. Okay, you got here n minus 4. What is the value of 4 here? You know, I'm taking the 4 value as n in generalized form. Okay, you can see very clearly here 2 to the power of 4. I'm taking that as n in generalized form. If I take that 2 to the power of n, then c remains c, n remains same. The 4 I have taken as in n as for a generalized form, for a generalized number. So n minus 1, n. Then for 3 you have, so this 2 to power of 3 means, for 4 I have taken n. So 3 means n minus 1. 2 square, what is it? For n, for 4 I have taken as n. So 2 square means 2, so n minus 2. So when I put it in a generalized form, this is what I'm supposed to get. Okay, this is what I'm supposed to get. Now, if I move to the further part of it, okay, if I move to the further part of it, see, I've got till here. One second, I'll move the screen. Okay, I got till here, but this is not what I want. I want it to be represented in a way where I can easily find out a time complexity in terms of theta. Okay, so what I can do? What I can do such that, you know, it will become more of a easier terms for getting to know this. We are going to get one thing called the geometric progression. We'll get to see that. Okay, before that, for this step, you got your C of 0 plus 2n minus 2n minus 1 plus 2n minus 2 up to n. It's up to 1. Okay, in the next step, what is this going to happen? 2 to power of n. Okay, be careful here, into 0 plus 2 to power of n minus 1 plus 2 to power of n minus 2 up to 1. Okay, then what's the next thing? Next thing, can I write this entire thing as, okay, please understand this, since this step, if you can understand this, it will become very easy. Okay, can I write this step of this entire thing as, then we'll get to know what is to be done under, okay. Two, this step is very important, be very careful here, okay. This is very important, okay. How I'm going to write this? Can I write this entire thing as 2 n to into 0, okay, as 2 n minus 1 plus 2 n minus 2 plus 2 n minus 3 up to 1. You know how I have written that. Okay, why has become like this? And where I start from? Okay, use one more color. Where I'm starting from in the next step. Okay, and where till where it goes. Now you see this. Now you see this, this is the most important part. This entire series what you see, okay? This entire series what you see is known as a geometric progression. Probably you would have heard of arithmetic progression, geometric progression, way back in your school level, and the same thing is coming through here also. Okay, if you don't know, please go back and you have to study. Otherwise, you just have to know that this is a geometric progression, okay? This entire above series is a geometric progression, okay? And the sum of all the terms can be calculated by a very simple, when you put all these things, okay? When you put all these things in form of a formula, it will become like this. See, now how did you get this? Even I don't know, okay? Because it's more like mathematics. Probably you must be, you know, asking Deepak sir of how it may come through and all, okay? Because I tried it. When I simplify the values, it will come. But how it is replicated for this, I'm not getting to, okay? So if I want to find out the sum of all those, all this geometric progression, okay? If I want to put it all those things as sum of n terms or sum of all the terms, okay? It can be represented like as S is equal to A R n to power of minus 1 divided by R minus 1. Now, what are the values? A value is equal to 1. R value is equal to 2. And n, of course, will be equal to your number of terms. Okay, number of terms, which will be nothing but equal to your n. Now, let's, if I put these values, what is going to happen? Okay, you can check very clearly. If A is equal to 1, then R is equal to 2. So it is 2 to power of n. Okay, then minus 1 divided by R minus 1. So it is 2 minus 1. So what is this going to happen? 2n to minus of 1. Okay, this is for first term. This is with regard to first term. If you put the value as, no, n is equal to 1, for one term, you are going to get 1. So that's fine. Okay, for 2, 2 power of 2, 4 minus 1, 3 terms, that's fine. Okay, with regard to when you put all these things into this, this is what you are going to get. You need to sort of buy at this or remember this, I don't know, okay? Something needs to be done. Okay, how this came through, you know, I don't know. Okay, they have put all these things as a geometric progression, and if you want to sum up all those terms, you can easily put it as like this using this formula. Probably would have learned this somewhere. Okay, then only they have come through like that, because I turned for, you know, putting two perspective of one term, second term and all. It works if I put the values, but how this is deduced for this, maybe there's some formula, you know, trying out a proof for it, not sure. Okay, so if you put these values into perspective, okay, with regard to one, substituting all the values in the above equation, what you get? You get like this, up to 2 to the power of n minus 1. For what? The first term. This, you know, a is equal to 1. Then, of course, if you put the number of terms as 1, then 2 to the power of 1 minus 1, so it is equal to 1. Okay, so if you put this, this is what you are going to get. Okay, if this is what you're going to get for a joint, you know, the time complexity of it at the end of it. And what you can write this as, C of n is equal to 2n minus 1, or in terms of theta, theta of 2n minus 1. Okay, or you can be, must be knowing very clearly, this minus 1 is a very relatively smaller value. When you compare to 2 to the power of n, this minus 1 is a very relatively smaller value. So what this can be written as? This can almost approximately written as, okay? This approximately, this can be written as theta of 2 to the power of n. Okay, this can easily be written as theta of 2 to the power of n. This is the place where you need to sort of remember things. Okay? This is something which you got to remember, just like how you remember the certain formulas. Okay, if you are able to remember this, then entire thing, see, if you can remember this, this is easy. Then you can remember this, this entire thing is pretty easy. Okay, this is how you find out the time complexity of all your recursive algorithms. Okay, recursive algorithms, you had something called as a factorial of a number. You had something called as a, you know, finding out the number of digits, okay, in a binary number. Then what you call as this one, which is with regard to Tower of Hanoi. Okay, there's one more thing called Fibonacci. Probably it's not there for the syllabus. If time permits, probably tomorrow we'll be, you know, sort of looking into it, or we'll be going into the next part of it. Anyway, the next few parts is all fully theory. Okay. All fully theory, depends on your PPTs and all that can be done. Okay, and also it is something which you have already learned. Okay, what is stats, what is queues, what is graphs, what is trees and all. So that is not an issue. But these things, see, you have three things here. Please keep this in mind. Three things right here, and also three things in the non-recursive thing, which is nothing but the iterative ones. Okay, what are the iterative aspects of it, right? So what are the three things that you learned there? That needs to be kept in mind. You would be remembering that one is theta of n, other one is theta of n square, other one is with regard to theta of n cube. Okay, this one is with regard to the sorting aspect, then this one unique element, this one matrix multiplication. Okay, like this, you need to sort of remember this, and also should be able to do the entire part. What are the three parts in this? The three parts in this is with regard to, first one is with regard to design. First, you need to write the design aspect of how we are going to write everything. This will be adding a little bit of theory, okay? How you are going to design an algorithm. Then yourself should be writing the algorithm. If you are designing an algorithm, here you need to write an algorithm. Then at the end, you need to write the analysis part. In analysis part, the things to be kept in mind is, find out that parameter. What is that parameter it depends on? It depends generally on n, which is nothing but the input. Then you need to find out the basic operation. What is that basic operation that is getting performed every time? Okay. And then you need to put those formulas all in form of mathematical form or in standard form. Okay. This will be a third part. And all these things, if they ask any problem, or among all these things, any problem they ask, it will be coming for 10 marks. And generally, the marks will be allocated like this. 5, and the next analysis part, entire thing will be 5 marks here and 5 marks here. Okay. If in detail, if you want, this will be 2, this will be 3. And this entire thing, finding out everything till at the last part will be 5 marks. Okay. The standard 10 marks question, two things. If you are lucky, you at least get two things among these two, among these six. Okay. If you are not lucky also, at least one is for sure. Okay. Why I'm saying not lucky? Because other things, then it will become theory, then you have to write a lot of things. Okay. Hopefully it will come. The next is only minute part of, you know, the theory things that are remaining in module one, which is, I know it's going to take a long, people may be thinking, you know, other subjects they complete, don't have to think about what is known as a quantity of syllabus. It's a quality of things that to be remembered here. Okay. Now in module, there's a lot of small thing which is with regard to stacks, okay, graphs, what is, you know, trees, you know, going to learn about those things. Again, very minute things only. Again, you're going to learn. There's no in-depth analysis, just going to know what is all those things. That probably will be doing it in the tomorrow's class. Okay. If possible, I'll put that you know, Fibonacci also in form of your notes, because that one now it's not there, but it's a good example. That's what I feel. It's a good, very good example to know about the recursive statements, the complexity of recursive statements. Okay. Or probably you people may be remembering, okay, how you can write a, you know, Fibonacci recursive statement. Okay, see, you study recursion in semester 2, semester 3. If you put it in Fibonacci, you know, how generally it will be. So if I write, can write that as, you know, Fibonacci series of n. Okay, write that, you know, the first term, what will be the first term? Obviously, you know, 0. If n is equal to, you know, first term, only one term. Then what's the second term? Okay, two terms means, you know, it is nothing but equal to 1. Okay, otherwise what you do with this, everyone probably will be knowing of what, n minus 1 plus Fibonacci of n minus 2, where otherwise anything otherwise your two terms, this is what you generally get. Okay, or in very simple terms, n greater than 2 means Fibonacci means this is what you're going to get. This is a very simple, you know, example which I like a lot, especially when I'm talking about recursion. When it comes to recursion, there are two things which people can always remember. One is with regard to factorial of a number, and the other one is with regard to Fibonacci. These two form a very, very good example for explaining recursion. Because there's so much thing that, you know, just by looking at it, people will be able to understand, okay, what is recursion? Okay. So if possible, I'll put this through when it comes to, you know, in your notes and all, written notes. Okay. So otherwise, we could always, you know, read those six and you could, you know, sort of go for the exam part of it.